What's up, Desperation Church? Welcome to Converge Online. On behalf of Pastors Andy and Leah Heiss, we're so thankful that you joined us. My name is Adam, and I'm our Jasper campus pastor. And listen, we are a church of prayer. This is really the heartbeat of Desperation Church. Man, we've seen so many amazing miracles and God stories come out of Desperation Church. And we believe that it is because we came together and prayed on nights like these. And so thankful that you're here. I want to share something with you. You know, during this time, especially COVID in 2020, there is so much talk. There's a lot of talk. There's a lot of social media posts. There's a lot of sermons being preached. And I get questions all the time from people that say, Pastor, do you think that we are living in the last days? Do you think we're living in the end of days? And to be honest with you, man, it looks like it. But here's what I do know. What I do know is this, is that we are living in our last days. What I do know is that we are closer now today than we ever have been. And so my question is, what are we doing with this time? Are we living in fear? Are we hunkering down, hiding until Jesus shows up? What are we doing with this time? I would like to encourage you to really ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to you what you're doing, what your driving force is. Something that should be produced out of this time is something that we call the Great Commission. You hear Jesus say before he ascended into heaven, he said this, he said, go into all the world and preach the good news to every living creature. And I just want to ask you, who have you shared Jesus with this week? Who have you invited to church this week? Who have you served personally this week? Whose life have you made a difference in for the glory of God this week? Listen, church doesn't end when the service is over. As a matter of fact, church starts when the service is over. We're not called to come to church. We're called to be the church, okay? And he says, go into all of the world and preach the gospel. It's amazing how, you know, when we were in quarantine and we went online exclusively, how every single church automatically had a global platform. The Great Commission was taking place every single week. But even personally, I want to ask you something. What does your world look like? Who are the people in your world that need Jesus, that need encouragement, that need the gospel, that need you to come and serve them in some shape, form, or fashion to let them know that God loves you? I would encourage you tonight to ask the Lord to reveal to you, to open your eyes up to the people that he sees in your life that you need to see. That he's actually, because here's the deal, you work with who you work with on purpose. When you follow Jesus, guess what? Your life has just become on purpose. You don't hate Mondays anymore. Why? Because you're going to work on purpose. You look forward to Mondays on purpose. You don't hang out with just who you hang out with. You don't go to the gym with who you just happens to be there. You are there on purpose. And God can create so many divine appointments for people to come into contact with you so that you can give them Jesus, where you can invite them to church, serve them, and love them. So what are you doing? I think, especially now as the end times have been a conversation for a lot of people, that should never produce fear in us. It needs to produce an urgency of evangelism to reach people. We're not distracted by fear. We're not distracted by preparations of the end of the world. I believe that we need to be distracted by that which is lost. And we need to take as many people with us into the kingdom of God as possible. Why are we here on this earth? To know Jesus and to make him known. So let that be your prayer. Father, we love you. God, we thank you so much, God, for the honor of knowing you. And Father, I pray, God, because we know you, let the overflow of our heart be to make you known. Lord, reveal to us the people around us that need you. They need a touch from you. They need to know you. They need a relationship with you. And Father, use us to be that bridge that they walk across to meet you. I pray, God, that for all of us watching, all of us who are gathered here tonight, that we live lives that make it so easy for people to meet Jesus. Lord, we worship you. And Father, I pray, God, that we have the urgency that is not dictated by fear. It's not dictated by what we hear, God, but that we realize we are living in our last days. What are we doing with it? Father, if you can use anybody, Lord, you can use Desperation Church. You can use us to make heaven a bigger place. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.